Steph, welcome to the show. Introduce yourself for people watching.
I'm Stephanie Hurst. I'm a broadcaster, a presenter, and also a part of this year's Leeds International Festival of Ideas, which I'm really excited about.
Tell us a little bit about what you're involved in, because there's two aspects of what you're doing this year.
Yeah, I'm going to be chatting in a Q&A style to the incredible Catherine Ryan, who I'm really excited about meeting because I've never met her, I've never interviewed before, but I absolutely adore her work. And she's an incredible, fierce woman, and I think that's going to be great. So you can get tickets by going online and get them booked now, because I'm pretty sure it's going to sell out pretty fast. And also I'm part of a panel which is interesting for me. The panel is called Can We Ever Be Who We Want to Be? And I know from my own experience of knowing that from childhood something wasn't quite right, and growing up and mental health issues, you know, we've not been allowed to be, because society deems you cannot be who you want to be, you've got to fit this particular binary. Well, I'm here to say that you can, because I'm living proof.
What do you think was the turning point for you in realising that you had to try and find the person that you were meant to be?
I think when I was constantly thinking about taking my own life, I think I'd got to a point, because I've had this incredible radio career. I knew a couple of things from a real early age. One is that I wanted to be on the radio, and I knew that because there was something about radio. It's one of your first freedoms, along with when you get your first bike and you can go to the end of the street.
Yeah.
And then you risk it a little bit and you go to the next yeah. street and you feel you like you've gone on holiday.
Yeah.
And then the second freedom when growing up, I think, is when you get your first radio, because you can start to tune around the dial and you're no longer having to listen to what your parents listen to. You can make your own choices about pop music, or, you know, if you were growing up in the, we can go way back, if you're growing up in the 70s, 80s or 90s, you'd be tuning around the dial and then you'd find this guy late at night called John Peel. And you go, oh my God. And it was like a world of new music. But then I loved pop music as well, and all your Kylie and Jasons and all that kind of stuff in the late 80s. But you started to kind of tune around the dial, and that was a real freedom for me. And I fell in love with this thing called radio. So I knew from a very early age that I wanted to be on this thing, but I also knew that I wasn't a boy.
Mm.
So obviously when I came out, there were some different bits. But we sorted that, it all got fixed. But it wasn't until my 30s that I managed to actually find the strength. I don't know whether courage is the right name. It's more survival, actually, because I'd gone to my GP when I was 17 and told my GP about this. And he said to me, it was something along the lines of, I strongly recommend you don't take this path in life. You won't have a successful life, you'll lose family and friends, because that's apparently what happened years ago if you changed your gender, because my soul is female, my brain formed opposite to the way I came out. It's almost like, imagine that biology, do you know when if you're a drinker and you've had a few drinks, you'll wake up the next morning a bit woolly headed, and you'll put the TV remote in the fridge and you'll get everything the wrong way around, won't you, the butter on the sofa. And it's a bit like that, I think, with biology. Sometimes it gets things a little bit muddled up and things don't come out which we, the world, deems as normal, whatever that word is. And I just had to change things a little bit.
Part of your journey, I guess, is making those brave decisions, which of course it was brave, but also in helping other people understand that they have an influence over if we can be who we want to be. And the world isn't necessarily set up for people like you. It's made difficult for the LGBTQ community. So part of the job as well is convincing others they have a role in helping people be who they want to be.
I think when I've tried to explain to people about, you know, we all, when we're born, we all come out different. That's the beautiful thing about us humans, unless you're identical twins, of course. But even personalities can be different. They can be identical, but the personalities can be completely different. But children can be born with limbs that are different, learning difficulties, all sorts of stuff. And that's biology just, you know, having its little way. And that's what it did with me. My brain formed opposite to what I came out looking like. When I was at school, they used to say, you know, all the boys go to this side of the classroom, all the girls go to that side of the classroom. This is at preschool. Mm. And I would just go and sit with the girls because that was my natural state of comfortableness. Yeah. Like, over there, you. Stay there. And then they'd do it again. And then I'd be, we told you. Stay there. I'm like confused.
Yeah.
So I was saying things to my mum when I was little, going, I'm not a boy. Because I just knew, but you can't vocalise these kind of things. You don't have the vocabulary to be able to explain these kind of things. And my mum, you know, in the early 80s, didn't have, there was no Google. She couldn't look this up or anything like that. So she did probably what a lot of parents did and just went, you know, you push things under the carpet a little bit, don't you, and think and hope they'll go away.
Yeah, it will be a fascinating conversation as part of the Leeds International Festival. Looking forward to it.
Likewise.
And can't wait to see you there.
Fantastic.